Hello and welcome to episode 4 of Surprise, We Both Love Movies. We'd like to thank everyone who subscribed to us on YouTube and Facebook and everyone who shared our videos. We're really excited about this project and we hope that you are too. This week we'll be reviewing The Devil All the Time, a Netflix original. I first heard about this movie from a radio interview done with the writer a few weeks ago, and I was genuinely intrigued by his story about how he had worked in a paper mill for about 20 years before he seriously started writing, and how his story centered around a town called Knock 'em Stiff. How can you not want to find out about a story in a town called Knock 'em Stiff? So that's what got me started. This movie stars Tom Holland, Robert Pattinson, and Eliza Scanlon. So the movie really is kind of about a few connected stories that cover about 30 years. It's a story about morality, faith, justice, and consequences. It takes you on a journey of several generations and how growing up in this town of Knock 'em Stiff, which the author described as a very small town where you're related to 70% of the people that live there, you get to see Tom Holland's character kind of develop and grow up a little bit and realize that a lot of the things of the past often impact the things of the future.
How and why people from two points on a map without even a straight line between them can be connected is at the heart of our story in Knock 'em Stiff.
You ever think about how we ended up orphans living in the same house?
I know what my daddy did.
Some people would say it's just dumb luck.
You take pictures?
I do. I see a smile pretty enough to photograph, that is.
Others would tell you it was God's plan.
Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness.
That ain't no preacher. He's as bad as they got on the damn radio.
When people look back on it, they ain't had no other choice.
There's a lot of no good sons of bitches out there.
Excuse me, preacher. You got time for a sinner?
You know, I studied something. It's called the delusion. A belief that is untrue.
It is our delusion that lead us to sin. Delusions!
Some people were born just so they could be buried.
What I'm about to do, I do because I have to. Not because I want to.
This was a well-crafted movie, a well-crafted and difficultly designed story that really kind of shocks you at the beginning because talks a lot about faith early in the movie, but as you go along this journey, it's definitely worth the reward at the end. What did you think kind of about this movie, Aaron, when you first started watching it? I know it's a little different than most of the movies and films we watch.
Yeah, it is. And I went in watching this film with absolutely no expectations. I didn't know what the movie was about. I hadn't watched any trailers. And so this was a completely blind situation for myself. Mm-hmm. This movie does star a lot of famous people. You've got Tom Holland, you've got Robert Pattinson, Bill Skarsgård, who was in It as the clown. So he gets a lot more acting here, which he does a fantastic job. And you also have Sebastian Stan. Sebastian Stan is also from the Avengers fame. He plays Bucky. And a lot of people will not recognize him in this movie. He looks way different. So right off, this movie is pretty gripping. They promise a story that's going to connect everything together. And they kind of tell you this at the beginning, that they're taking you on a journey. I enjoyed the journey one time. I wouldn't want to go on the journey again. This is not an uplifting film. It is a very depressing film. The name is very appropriate for what the film is as well, but it's not an experience I would want to ever partake in again. you're right. It does talk a lot about faith at the beginning, and then it moves into showing you how pretty much everybody's infected by some kind of a whole nother side of it, basically. Unlike you, though, I didn't think the end paid off. I think there are far more films that have been released that do a much better job of crafting a story with a bunch of interconnecting characters.
And that's what I'd say about this movie. This is the type of movie for anyone who's ever wanted to like peek behind the curtain, so to speak. So it's people that society might label as crazy or unstable. And, you know, you might want to try to understand like, hey, how did that person get there? How does someone get to this decision that you can't comprehend?
Yeah, the movie, I wouldn't say I enjoyed it. there are some good performances in the film. And I honestly, the whole time I was hoping for more. Mm-hmm. I was hoping for a good payoff in the end. And the payoff for me was not worth the journey. And I don't want to take away from any of the performances because there were no bad performances in this movie.
I don't know. What about Robert Pattinson? I thought he did a stand-up job. I thought he tried really, really hard. But something just didn't resonate. I just didn't buy the idea that he was from this little town.
You do have to look at where this was filmed, you know, where it was supposed to take place. There's a whole part of our country that there's some dark history in the past. And this kind of brings up some of the kind of twisted nature of the way religion it used to be viewed and maybe is sometimes still viewed today in those areas.
Oh, great.
And it's not a good look for anybody. And right. So in that regard, I didn't like the film in really any way. This movie was not fun. It had good performances. Mm-hmm. And you're right. I think Pattinson was the worst part of it, but I wouldn't say his part was terrible.
No.
His part was, you know, I think he was the scummiest person in the whole movie.
Right.
And I don't know. I haven't seen, everyone talks about how an amazing actor he is. I haven't seen it in anything he's done yet. So
I would agree with you. I haven't seen it yet. I'm not saying laughing down the road, but as of yet, he's not there.
You know, he's going to be in Batman, so I've got my eyes on that, but I'm really worried. I just don't know what to make of him yet. I haven't seen anything that's made me go, wow, and this definitely didn't do it. All the performances were good. Was anything great to me? No, nothing was great. For me, this seemed like a made-for-TV movie.
Wow.
It did not have a sense of, I would not have paid to see this. I don't think this would have gotten enough buzz to be an actual film released in the theater. I don't think you'd get enough people to go see it because of the subject matter. And there are no breakout stars in this. You had a little bit of everybody. Everybody played their part, but nobody stood out amongst anyone else. They all had their individual parts. Will I remember this movie enough? Will I ever want to watch it again? Absolutely not.
So it felt more like a play. Like if you really, when you watch the movie, it almost feels like a play or some type of theater type
that
of performance, because that's really kind of what it is. It's more of a character study than it is a movie, is what I'd like to say. It's definitely one of those things where you have this big idea. And also I forgot to mention that the movie takes place in the 1940s through the 1960s, about somewhere right around there.
And we're right in that area.
In that part of, in Ohio in that time. And you realize that, you know, a lot of things happened back in those days and people never knew, you know, like it wasn't like you had somebody sitting there with like a cell phone camera recording, you know.
Right.
Truth was left up to whoever was left to tell the story. And, you know, you don't really, that's not a world that we live in really too much today, but it was very much the world of that time. And it was a little bit off-putting, I think, at times when I was watching it. I'm like, you know, if this and this and this happens, only this person knows. Or if this and this and this happens, only this person knows. And there's probably a lot of wrongdoings and misdeeds that of that time that was never widely known, you know. Today, in today's world, something happens, you hear about it within
instantly.
A minute, you know.
Instantly, yes.
Right away, you'll know, hey, this happened. And it was interesting to see how that probably worked back then. And I think it's definitely a more just time compared to then after watching this movie.
Yes.
But what's your final review of The Devil All the Time?
Okay, so my final verdict on this, I give it a 3.
Okay.
Simply because it's not fun subject matter. It's not a movie I would have chosen to see. Mm-hmm. It's just not it just didn't hit me. It didn't seem great. So I'd give it a 3 for a movie. Mm-hmm. Film, I think I'd put it in the, well, probably give it a 5.
Okay.
Give it a 5. I think if you wanted to study it and look at it as a character study, yeah. Film, as a movie, not feeling it.
All right. All right. Well, for me, what I like to say is that I was able to, it's not a movie. It's a film. Understand that. If you're going to spend the time watching this, it's a film. All right. My film score is, I give it an 8 out of 10 because it really did do a good job of exploring the human condition. Is it something that I'd go back and watch again? I don't really know, but is there something, if I went back to watch it, that I could pull from it that I maybe didn't catch the first time, or some themes that were underlying that I missed? I think I could. You know, to me, it kind of reminded me of a dramatic version of Seven. You know, when you watch Seven the first time, you're like, I don't think I ever need to see that again. That was pretty traumatic. And that's almost kind of what type of movie this is, in the sense of it being more of a theater drama type of story. For as far as a movie's concerned, it's not a movie. I felt like if you probably sat down and said, oh, you know, Spider-Man's in this and I want to watch this, you'd be greatly disappointed. I gave it a 6 out of 10 as a movie review. But if you're a film buff, I think you can appreciate it if you can be okay with the content not being necessarily uplifting and not necessarily happy-go-lucky. If you're just looking at it as a character study, I think you'll find that the characters are interesting and it's worth your time. So for this week, that's all we have. I'm Lamont Lovejoy.
I'm Aaron Fisher.
And we'll see you guys next week.